sort of graze. I think she'll win at short notice and then maybe go on with the job. And there's your favourite in Stolen Dance for David Green and Sam Spratt. The draw is just the awkward part of this race. So we'll see if we can catch up with David's stable foreman or rep here at Opony today. Spin Doctor, 640, 180. What a horse he is. Three Breaking Dawn at 150. Capone, 290. 2 and 3. 12-6. Stolen Dance, really, in a horse that, gee, made an impression on debut. No favours last start.
Yeah, look, she's a filly that we've got a... She's got a bit of promise there. She was very unlucky last start at Ellerslie. Bit of a forget run, so money's up today, so we thought we'd have a crack.
Okay, draws probably the most awkward part.
Yeah, look, we'll try and get midfield with cover somewhere and we'll leave the rest to Sam. Hopefully she gets the job done.
Okay. What's sort of the plan for this type of horse with David? Is moving on to the bigger three-year-old events?
There is thought about going to Royal Stakes, but we'll just see how she pulls up. There's a race at Tarapa on the 17th that we might use to lead into the Sir Tristram Fillies race, so that's an option as well.
Okay, how'd the horse travel?
Yes, she travelled down well. She's got herself a bit toey today, which is a little bit of concern, but we'll see how we go.
Okay, best of luck.
Thank you, Bevan.
There's Sam, who's representing David today with the $3.40 favourite. We might quickly pick up our jockeys that we recorded earlier, and the first of those, Kelly Moyes, she is on the top of the book. Race 4, Kelly Seal by Dance, who's been against the older horses and competitive and good three-year-old New Zealand at the moment.
Yeah, absolutely. Trained by the Logans, of course, Volkstock and Barrel. He has got plenty of X Factor about him. And don't forget a horse called Turn Me Loose, too. He's got the Group 1 next to his name anyway at this stage of the season. Race number 4, yeah, you're right about this race being an open affair, but like him, like everyone else, I thought Stolen Dance was a good thing, a tragedy beaten last time out. Sam Spratt to do the riding. I am a little bit concerned about her. She was a little bit worked up in the prelim, as Sam mentioned in that interview, and he did a great job too. I watched him, he lead the horse out onto the track, then ran about the 250, 300 metres to you, and managed to get through that interview without stammering too much or being out of breath too much, but he's in pretty good nick himself. So yeah, 10 Stolen Dance, but the concern is that she's just got herself a little worked up, but she can gallop. She is very, very smart. I think she can win if she's in the right frame of mind. A 1 Sealed by a Dance for second. I'll put in number 2, A Red Prince, and 4 Highland Park with the addition of the blinkers, as Opie mentioned in that interview. 10, 1, 2 and 4.
Thanks, George.
Who shot the Barman colours? We're set to go. Ritual Stud, 3-year-old premier. Gates open, they're off. And racing in Highland Park, bounced the gate to lead in the early stages. Joby lands handy with OK Jack. Favourite Stolen Dance from a wide gate is moving forward now to be on the speed as well. That'd be followed out by Silk Belt and out wide a Trojan. Along the inside is Court Master, and in that group also is a Red Prince. 2 lengths away, Nymph Monte from Potatini Diva. 2.5 back to Sealed by a Dance, who got back third last from Dixie Express. And 2 lengths away, Q0 is last of all. And the run down past the 1,100 metres mark. And the favourites made the lead on the outside. Stolen Dance from on the inside of it, Joby. They match motors in front. Lying third and out in the cheap seats, 3 wide is Trojan. It'll be followed through by Courtmaster over on the inside with Highland Park between those two. So you swing off the back, 750 to run. A gap of 3 lengths away, OK Jack. Then came Silk Belt from Potatini Diva. Further back in the field is a Red Prince. Then Nymph Monte from Sealed by a Dance, who's still only got 2 behind it. They are Dixie Express and Q0. Up towards the home turn now. 500 metres to go. Pacemaker Joby from on the outside of it. Now is the favourite Stolen Dance as they turn in. Highland Park is out after these. Wider out we've got Trojan. Further back then to Nymph Monte. Then came a Red Prince and wider out Sealed by a Dance. Stolen Dance made the lead now at the 200 metres. Highland Park's going to have the last run at it. Battling on Joby, and behind them Nymph Monte's getting out late as well, but Stolen Dance still in front and is defying them as it goes to the post. She's good. Stolen Dance won it. Nymph Monte dashed into second. Third, Highland Park, and then followed over by Joby. Wider out, Sealed by a Dance, ran on late, followed by Silk Belt. Then came Dixie Express, a Red Prince. Further away was Trojan, with it also Court Master. Then Q0, followed by Silk Belt, and well back towards the tail of the field also would have been OK Jack. That'll be the last of them home. Number 10, Stolen Dance. For David Green and Sam Spratt, $2.80 it closed off at. She was a little fired up in her prelim, and she worked overtime from an outside gate, got on the outside of the leader. She was a sitting duck for them to run her down over the final stages, but she kept on giving the filly by Alamosa, and this has been a brave win. Nymph Monte, eye-catching in second. Highland Park will be third. Joby will be the fourth of them home ahead of Sealed by a Dance running on late. And then Potatini Diva. But at the line at number 10, Stolen Dance, start number three, win number two.
Pretty smart too, George, after working hard. Here's the judge.
10, Stolen Dance. 6, Nymph Monte, second. 4, Highland Park, third. 5, Joby, fourth. 1, Sealed by a Dance, fifth. 14, Potatini Diva, sixth. 10, 6, 4, 5, 1, 14.
So it will be the 10 in the book. David Green, Transit to Upper Sam Spread in the saddle, and I've got Stable Rep and Part Owner. Well done, Sam. Congratulations. Super effort after what sort of unfolded early in the run.
Yeah, look, Sam put her in the race today, which was a positive, and she rode like the best horse in the race. She did the job.
Yeah, well, she got challenged by Holland Park, who's a smart type of horse, and she really showed a bit of stretch, so you've got some pretty positive things to work with.
Yeah, look, we'll just see how she pulls up and have a look at some black type now. And, yeah, awesome.
Yeah, look, she made you sweat yourself. She was a fair old handful early.
Yeah, look, she got wound up a bit. Always the case when David's not here, but never mind. Got the job done today and be a good trip home.
Big family affair in this ownership?
Yep, the whole family are in it, and Dad's got some of his mates in the Tokemuta Judge Syndicate as well, so that's probably why you heard us in the stand.
Okay, exciting times. Congratulations.
Thank you, Bevan.
There's Sam, who is part owner and stable rep around what clearly is a pretty smart horse, Stolen Dance, the three-year-old filly. Like, she had to work a little bit overtime early in the run, but once she got there, she settled nicely, and she's shown a bit of stretch. Highland Park had a crack, and then she fought him off. And look, Nymph Monte, that's a massive improvement from last start in that three-year-old race at Trentham. Just has jumped out of the ground late in the piece, and nice performance for Grant Nicholson and Rory. He did give you that sort of lead before the race when we did his little clip. He said this horse will bounce back today, and look, it really has. So the 10 will be heading maybe Royal Stakes Day on the first at Ellerslie. We'll talk to Sam, get her thoughts around this horse's ability. She was wound up, so she's done a wonderful job with the run she got as well. 10 to beat 6, the 4 Highland Park will win up, and I thought, well, she's going to go on by, or he's going to go on by, but just battled the last little bit. And then Joby, he'll run the first 4. He was brave again. Little horse who's got a little bit of ability up. So we'll grab Sam and have a quick chat around a pretty talented 3-year-old filly. Look, she wound herself up, and look, you had to work early, so she's got a lot of ability.
Yeah, she did. Hey, she had to work early, but on the other hand, she was doing it pretty easy. Yep. She jumped and put herself there. Wasn't going to be as handy as we were, but she jumped and was there. I thought, I'm not going to pull her back rider like the best horse, so very good.
She felt a bit of pressure from Island Park and responded pretty positively to that.
Yeah, she did. You know, when I turned her home, the one on the inside, I was hoping it would actually come into a little more than it did, but very tough effort.
Okay, so they talked maybe a Royal Stakes on New Year's Day, up to that sort of level?
Yeah, I think so. You know, like, hey, was a bit worked up, but my trip down here and everything, education's only going to make her better.
Well done, Tim.
Thank you very much.
Now the smart type here, Aiden at Awapuni, Stolen Dance. She's a beautiful cut of a horse. Look, she didn't have everything in her favour today, but